Hello and welcome to Study with Sudhir, your digital classroom. February 27th is day one of the ICSE Class 10 board exams. And I thought we should do a video explaining to students how to really do time management during the exam, because many students are confused whether they should follow the sequential order, that is question number 1 first and question number 5 last, or can they actually go in a random order, and how will the examiner react if the order is a bit jumbled up. Now, I thought, let me clarify this, because there's too much of confusion and too many comments saying our teacher said this, our school said this, will our marks be cut, will the examiner be offended, blah blah blah. Number one, you are free to follow any sequence. Let that be very, very clear. I repeat, you can answer questions in whatever order you please. In fact, the thumb rule is that you should always attempt that question first whose answer you know the best, because that is what puts the best, gives the best impression to the examiner. You will always put your best foot forward, isn't that so? So if you are not strong in the composition question, why on earth would you attempt that first? Elementary. So, and give a slightly poor impression, I mean not the best impression at least, to the examiner. That is the thumb rule. But having said that, there is no one size fits all. Some of you would be very good in comprehension and summary. Some of you would be very good in letter writing and notice and email. Some of you would be good in essay. And many of you would be very good in grammar. I will give you three different options. See, first of all, as I have already explained in videos before, the first 15 minutes you should focus on looking at the essay, deciding on which essay you will write. Now, there is no provision for you to write down your points anywhere at that point in time, because you are not allowed to write anything on the question paper except the tick mark which you are allowed to put on the each question after you have finished attempting them, right? So you are not allowed to write anywhere on the question paper. Okay, so that's ruled out. You will be given the answer sheet in those 15 minutes, but only to write in your unique ID number, roll number, etc. And on day one, there would be the extra checks which will, mandatory checks which will be done by the invigilators. So you can start writing only at 11 a.m. So what do? You just kind of remember all those points of whichever essay form, the original story, the argumentative or the narrative, whatever you choose, you just remember it at that point in time during those 15 minutes. You should also look at the grammar portion, because if you are able to crack the grammar portion fast, you'll be able to write it out fast. You won't waste time then thinking about which preposition will come, which verb will come, etc., etc. Then also read the comprehension. Now, comprehension is a little tricky, because you may need to read it at least twice or even thrice, especially if it is a slightly complicated passage, unseen passage, or if it is from a foreign country. That also makes it a little tricky for many students. That has been my experience. So you need to read it at least once during that time, and also decide on what letter you will write, the formal letter or the informal letter. You know, just go through everything so that your mind is able to decide, okay, this will be the option I will exercise. That is what you should do in those 15 minutes. Done. 15 minute ho gaye, 11 o'clock, clock strikes. Now you can start writing. Sequence number one, you follow the same sequence, but only students who feel they are good in writing the essay. Only those students, I repeat, who think they are able to write the composition well, and even more importantly, are able to write the composition in not more than 25 to 30 minutes. If you are going to take time till 11:45, sorry, you are messing up your entire time management. So, if you are confident that your essay is going to give the best impression to the examiner and you can finish it off in half an hour, within half an hour, please go ahead and write it in sequential order starting from question number one. Okay, I hope this is loud and clear. Then you can go to anything, letter writing, email, notice, comprehension, grammar, you can follow the sequential order. In my opinion, and this is my opinion, and this is also the opinion of a large number of teachers who I have interacted with, even students, based on students' experience of previous 10th class students, including Tejaswini, that you start with the grammar first. Now, grammar is question number 5, which has the verbs, prepositions, do as directed, and adding the sentence, combining the sentence without using and, but, or so. You are able to actually finish this off in lesser amount of time, because you see, there are essentially 4 parts to the question paper: essay, unseen passage, grammar, and the letter writing and the notice email together. 20, 20, 20, 20. Fine. So, 4 hours, you approximately have about a half an hour for each 20 mark section, right? Mentally, I mean, that's how you should divide your time. So, if you are able to finish off the grammar portion, that is question number 5, in less than half an hour, you actually save that time which you could use for your either your unseen passage, letter writing, or for even for your essay. That's a bonus you get. You know, you feel that, okay, you have finished it in 20 minutes instead of taking 30 minutes over it. Okay. One thing you need to take care of, and this is very important, is that when you're starting question number 5, go in order. Don't start with question number 5, C, then go to A, then go to D, then go to B. No, don't do that. Go 5A, 5B, 5C, 5D. That's the order. Don't jumble up this order. And this is what I always say. You can change the sequence of the main question, but do not change the sequence of the sub-questions. If you don't know any particular verb or any particular preposition, leave that space and come back to it later during the revision time that you can allot an extra 5 to 10 minutes at the end, 11:50, 11:55, around that time. Also, many students have been asking me, are we expected to write the entire sentence for prepositions or for verbs? No, you're just expected to write the number clearly and write the verb or the preposition against it. You're not expected to write the entire sentence. You don't have to waste your time doing that. You can finish with grammar, finish it off by 11:20, 11:25 if you are really quick at it. Then you can go to letter writing, notice email, then you go to comprehension. Because what happens is that summary ends up taking a lot of time. So you wouldn't want to kind of spend a lot of time and compromise your letter writing and notice email quality in the bargain. So till 11:45, 12, before 12, if you're able to finish letter writing, email along with grammar, you have finished 40%, 40 marks of the 80 marks. And then you come to comprehension, the unseen passage and the summary. And then finally the essay, that would be the order I would follow. Now, there are some students who prefer, and this is the third option, some students who prefer to use those first 15 minutes to look through the entire passage, unseen passage, very, very carefully. And also with the light touch of a pencil, just mark the keywords for the pressy writing. You know, some invigilators may be a little, not very happy about it. So you need to be careful. I wouldn't want you to take any risks whatsoever on day one of your board exams with the invigilator, because you don't know the invigilator, how he or she may react to a situation where he or she sees you marking something with a pencil. So just be very careful, which is why I said summary writing during those 15 minutes preparing for it, it can be a little tricky. But if you are able to go through it many times, see the questions, and if you feel that you want to attempt it straight away, you could actually go ahead and do that. Or what you could do is that you could finish off the entire thing, make the grid, leave it, you can come back to the pressy writing later. If you want to do that, if you think your unseen passage is your best, you will be best at the solving the unseen passages. You know those three words whose meanings have to be given. So at the end of the day, it all depends on what you think you are good at. Okay, so if, as I said at the beginning, if you think you're good at unseen passage, you're think good at essay, go and follow that order. But essentially, ensure that your opening batsman is able to create the best impression. Ye bahut zaruri hai. Because tail enders sometimes are not able to bat very well. But in this case, if you are able to kind of ensure that grammar will be able to deal with it faster, then come to letter writing and notice email, also that may not take much time, and then devote the larger chunk of the time to both the summary writing, which again I repeat takes time, and the essay writing takes time. So all these things, and actually while you are writing thing, you may be able to get better ideas to write your essay instead of, you know, writing it right at the beginning at around 12:15. I could have thought of that point. Then you cannot go back to the essay and make corrections. Whereas in grammar, if you have made a mistake, you just need to strike out the in and write another preposition, say whatever, you know, at. You know, you could make the changes. Essay may, you will not be able to make the changes. Which is why, in a very scientific way, I keep saying essay attempted at the end. It's in the best interest of everyone. It's not as though, you know, just because the examiner is going to see the essay at the end, he's going to give you less marks. Aisa nahi hota hai. They will read the entire thing. Another remark which many students I don't know whether it's deliberate or in ignorance they make, is that the examiners will read only the first 200 words. Who's told you that? I mean, who spreads such canards and rumors? They read the entire 300 to 350 words that you have written. Yes, it is possible that if you have written a really pathetic essay, that it's possible that they may lose interest in reading your essay after the first 100, 150 words. That's possible, if you have really written it bad. But if anyone has written a decent essay, it may not be brilliant, but if it's a good effort, a good essay, the examiner will definitely read the entire essay. Even in the other, even if it's a poor essay, the examiner will read it. He may not show much interest, or he may just kind of be a little put off. But it's not right to say that the examiners will not read the entire essay, or that they will read only the first 200 words. No. Again, I repeat, essay, I said this in the essay video lesson also. I don't know whether you didn't listen to it. Giving the title is important, it's necessary, it gives a character to your essay. Irrespective of whether it's an original story or an argumentative essay or a narrative essay or whatever be the form. If you give a title, it gives a character to thing, and if its a title is good, it will interest the examiner. You can write the title at the end. When I say at the end, is you have to write it at the top, but you can write it sequentially at the end. You can leave those two lines and write it in bold letters right at the top. Okay? You are not supposed to write your name anywhere after the essay. It cannot be the title of the essay and written by T.S. Sudhir. You cannot write your name over there. So let that be very clear. The only place where your name can come in the English language paper is in the letter writing. Is in the letter writing and also in the email it could come. These are the only two places where your name can be mentioned, which is perfectly all right. The examiner will assume it's a fictitious name. There's absolutely no problem with that. One student asked whether we can write to names like Shylock, Portia, this thing. I mean, it would be seen as cheeky. And I personally wouldn't advise any student to take such a risk with an examiner. Suppose the examiner thinks, you know, over smart student hai, you know, what does he think of himself, and decides to cut half a mark. Why would he want to take a chance like that? Write any name, na? I mean, zarurat nahi hai. I mean, there's no need to be cheeky in an examination. So that's as far as the time management is concerned. I hope this is loud and clear. All the best to you. Use this day well in preparing for your first exam. Thank you very much for watching.